Bobcats, welcome back to the thankful edition of your BBTV News. We're your hosts,
Lucas Riley
and Jenna Vergara.
Our club is selling Fannie Mae chocolate for the thrifty price of $2, so if you want a sweet treat, your solution lies there.
But don't eat it if you're wearing the new spicy Beecher apparel, because it will get all brown and sticky. If you want some of that apparel, find one of the flyers around the building. It'll tell you how you can get access to the online store.
Absolutely.
It closes on December 1st, so make sure you get your stuff no later than that.
Now, just because school is ceasing sessions after today does not mean that the athletics do. The Fall Classics will continue to take place tonight and tomorrow night, so you should check it out. It's going to be right here at Beecher.
Now, if you've ever laughed, then you would know that stuff can be funny. Mm-hmm. Our first segment is called Innuendo Bingo. And I don't know, there's water involved and stuff.
Do some magic.
You?
Magic Charles. It says talent.
Any questions? Are you going to finish that croissant?
Knock yourself out. Let me assure you.
Hi, welcome to Chile.
So I built this cage to keep him secure so there's no possible... Oh my...
What I want...
Oh my...
How do you keep your pants up when you're performing? It's incredible.
Belt.
Now that was epic. But what can top that?
I'm pretty hungry. I could use some food.
Oh, you know, I have an idea. Have you ever had sweet potato casserole, dude?
Quite. My dad made it once.
Oh. Well, I want to make it. All right, right now, I want to make sweet potato casserole. I'm going to go make it in the kitchen. This feels weird. Whatever. I'm used to not filming myself doing weird things because I'm not a bad YouTuber. Anyway, today we're making sweet potato casserole with snaps, too. So, we're going to start by heating up the sweet potatoes because if you've ever eaten a sweet potato, it's probably been cooked. If you ate it raw, it would be bad. I assume... because I've never eaten a raw potato. Wait. Right, so we're gonna use this knife, and before we heat up those sweet potatoes in the microwave, we need to do two things, all right? So we're going to wash these sweet potatoes, and it's going to be great, because they're gonna be clean, and we'll have clean food, all right? So now that they're dried off, we have one more thing to do to them before we yeet them up. and that is poke some holes into them. I'm just gonna use a paring knife, all right? This little boy from the dollar store is what we're going to use to poke some holes into our sweet potato, because if we don't poke these holes in there, then it will actually explode. Now that our sweet potatoes are ooing in the microwave, we can start getting some other stuff together, all right? So, other ingredients we need for this sweet potato casserole, sweet potato part, is going to be 2/3 of a cup of some sugar. We're gonna cut it out with some butter knife. So that's 2/3 of a cup. The next thing we need is some soft butter, all right? We're gonna need to soften this butter, all right? Now, this is good quality butter. It is double A, which means like, you know, A plus butter. And we're going to need to soften 1/3 of a cup of this, which is going to be about 2/3 of this stick. So it's going to be great. Now, we get these eggs. They're egg flavored. They are also egg shaped, which is crazy. And we're going to, don't do that. We're going to crack them into this bowl, all right? So we're going to take this butter and we're going to plop it right in. With that egg. That's going to be nice. We're going to mix this stuff in there. Alright, so you make sure it's all nice and melty, but not melted, but melty, if you know what I'm talking about. Alright, well, my camera said goodbye and it died. So, needing another fork right now. We have, I don't feel like redoing it because that'd be a waste of everything ever. So, basically I put brown sugar in there. You saw that go down. I put 1/2 cup of flour in there, and I put 1 cup of pecans. Now we need one more thing. So we got this all mixed in, but we do need the melted butter to go in there still. Alright, now that we have this butter nice and melted, we're going to throw this right in there, right? Ooh, it's like mashed potatoes, but different, I guess. I don't know. We're going to mix it all in there, and it's going to turn into kind of like a almost crumbly little thing, and that's what we're going to put on top of the sweet potatoes once we have that totally done. We're going to get this potato out of there. Now, I'm just going to show this one because, you know, there's like 6 or 5 other ones to do, so I'm not even going to bother with it. So you just kind of want to eat it right out. Make sure your hands are washed because you might be touching some potato, you know? So we're just going to put this in a bowl over here, no stress. You're just going to kind of get as much as you can, right? All right. Now that we have all these potatoes peeled, see, look at how much this is. This is way more than 3 cups. But we're just gonna throw it in with it anyway, all right? We're going to wanna electric mix this because we like convenience in our lives, right? So, oh yeah, all right. So let's see. Just gonna keep plopping it in. It's gonna be very, very nice. Alright, so now that we have it at the consistency and color of the visualization of if a traffic cone threw up, we are going to put it in an 8x8 pan. Alright, now, before we put this sweet potato stuff in there, we gotta grease this pan. It's gonna be delicious stuff, but it won't be delicious if we can't get it out of the pan. So we're just gonna spray the bottom of this, spray the sides. Try not to spray on my shirt. Alright, now that is sufficiently and thoroughly greased, we are going to start applying, if you will. You won't. You wouldn't say apply, but you would say you would throw that sweet potato stuff in there, right? It's going to be, as they say in some countries, so good tasting, your socks will burn off your feet. Make sure your hands are clean for this part, because we are going to put on this crumbly stuff, this topping that we have made. Look at that. Oh, this is going to be so heckin' good. Like, you won't even have any feet. You know, I feel like MJ Gonzalez with how much I'm talking about feet right now, but, you know, I think it's worth it. I think that this topping and this the bottoming and the topping are gonna combine and make some good meal. So this is what it's gonna be looking like before you throw it into the oven, right? It's looking pretty good, but you're like, man, that could look better. Once it's done cooking, Man, it's going to be so nice. You're going to cook this for about 30 minutes, I want to say. Yeah, I think 30 minutes at 350 degrees. It's going to be some good tasting casserole. I could roll with it, in my opinion. You'll see once it's done. It is time, lads. Oh, look at this beauty. Do you see this beauty? And it's just looking really nice right now to me. So I can't eat it till Tuesday in production. This is what I'm making this for. And I was like, I'll film it too, you know, why not? And then I'm making one for Thanksgiving, and then I'm making one for my second Thanksgiving. I have so many Thanksgiving because my parents are divorced. So that means I get more food. And that's the only thing that we can take away from a divorce. Goodbye.
Ah, that was delicious. It's like he never left. Mm-hmm. Well, that was... I hope it was tasty. That's one thing. I mean, do you know what's scary?
Disappointing my entire family?
No. Turkeys. Yeah. Turkeys are pretty scary. Yeah.
This winter... One turkey. One high school. One dinner. With the disappearance of Linus the pig, Tickle the turkey roams the high school.
You know how Miss D was cooking some of that food? Her students were cooking that food.
Oh, they cooked it so hard.
Yeah, we went into their classroom to see what they were doing.
Mm-hmm. It was fantastic.
This is what we found. Mm-hmm.
Today we are here to interview people about the Thanksgiving food they are cooking today.
They're cooking it. It's going to be delicious.
I was making this
pumpkin
pie.
I made that. It's not even baked.
I'm about to start making this pumpkin pie.
He doesn't even know what he's talking about.
I've started cooking these cranberries right here. And I started doing the dishes.
Logan, you're bad.
You didn't do anything.
So, I love Thanksgiving.
Hello. So, I'm good. How are you?
All right.
So what are we cooking over here in kitchen two?
They're cooking, I think pies or something.
They're cooking?
Yeah. I have the most important job. Washing and drying dishes, as well as putting them away.
Hello, Logan. How's it going?
It's going good.
Looks like you got a lot to eat here.
Yeah, I'm a hungry boy. I gotta grow.
How's the head chef enjoying his meal?
It's really good so far. It's a little hot, so always blow on your food before you eat it.
Misty has to come in at 5 in the morning.
Why?
to put the turkey in the oven.
Obviously, but like...
Turkey has to be done before 9, so it's got to get cooking fast.
I suppose so. Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
This was a lovely time. Thank you, guys.
Oh, no problem. Brittany?
I don't know what else my group is cooking. Good stuff.
Are there mashed potatoes or is it just twice baked?
I think it's just twice baked.
Twice baked. That's like mashed potatoes, but yeah. with a shell. Yeah. Yeah. Well, what's been your favorite thing to make so far then?
In foods class the whole year.
Let's limit it to Thanksgiving for today because that's what we care about. Okay. It's that episode.
We haven't eaten anything yet, but maybe the pumpkin pie looks the best.
Let's go to the boys and see what people in Beecher High School are thankful for.
I'm thankful for stuttering.
Thanks, Sars.
Steve?
Hey, yo, JP, what's good?
What's good, sis?
Dang, ain't much. So, everybody want to know what you're thankful for.
I'm thankful to be able to wake.
What's your favorite food on Thanksgiving?
Cranberry sauce.
Wake up in the morning, I got family that loves me, and I've got dogs that love me, and I've got food and a roof over my head. That's what I'm thankful for.
It sounds like a really great life.
So what are you doing this Thanksgiving?
Probably the same thing I've done the past like 3 years. Get along with like my whole like three families and just have the whole like parranda pone, you know, all the Mexican music, whole party and everything. Probably have like all the good food.
I know exactly what she's talking about.
Yeah.
What's your favorite food on Thanksgiving?
Cranberry sauce.
So what are you doing for Thanksgiving this year, man?
Going to my grandma's, gonna eat a bunch of food, gaining a lot of weight, and mostly just chill.
That's what's up.
Nothing too special.
Alright, for sure. I'm just trying to know what you're gonna get when you go Black Friday shopping.
I really need a new controller.
Well, what happened to the old one?
The LB button fell off.
It sucks.
Oh yeah, I can't play Fortnite.
That's rough.
What is your favorite holiday throughout the whole holiday season?
I don't like all of them. I only like Halloween.
What? What about Christmas?
Nah.
Oh my gosh. Not Thanksgiving?
I like Thanksgiving, but Halloween is my number one.
New Year's. How about that one? Halloween's a good one, though. That's a good one. All right, there you have it, folks.
Now, one more thing happened recently, and it was just this last Saturday, and that was called ILMEA. And your boy Jed and Jayla Kellum were in it, and they both did absolutely flawlessly, and we have some video to prove it.
Sing, sing unto God, sing, sing, ye kingdoms of the earth, oh, sing.
I bet you're very thankful for us, and we are thankful for you, our forest viewers.
But that's all from us this week. We genuinely hope you enjoy your Thanksgiving break, and eat a lot of food, please.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it.
Sweet
potato casserole.
Gluttony is good.
Absolutely. We'll see you next time. All right, kids. Good night, Bobcats.